Some people made it. Well, good morning. For us, it feels like really like afternoon. It was 4 a.m. this morning when we left the Netherlands and flew in. So it's good to be here. And it will be a nice session about enterprise mobility. My name is Ruben, or Ruben, that's fine as well. I'm the CTO of a company called PQR. We are a system integrator and based in the Netherlands. I'm a CTP, an MVP, and a V expert. And together with my colleague Peter, we will we'll have an enjoyable session, hopefully, and a valuable session around enterprise mobility.
Yeah. My name is Peter Sterk. As Ruben explained, I work for the same company, PQR. I work as solution architect, and I'm primarily focused on application desk delivery concepts, and of course, enterprise mobility management. And in my day-to-day role, I advise our customers with how to solve IT problems within that scope, application desk delivery, and speak on national events on these topics, application desk delivery, and of course, enterprise mobility management.
So we are from Holland. We are proud to be Dutch. In Holland, we ate this kind of stuff. Stroopwafels, very famous. When we have some off time, we drink some Heineken, well known as well. And when we have some time after prepping all our sessions, writing white papers, doing webinars, consulting with customers, we ride our bicycle and sniff through the tulip fields. So PQR, the content we create is our content. It's no vendor specific stuff included, so vendors didn't pay us. It's our own content, and well, as you will see later on, the EMM SmackDown white paper is PQR content. Objectives for this this morning, objectives are very simple, is talk about users, users control it, or users control IT. Talk about application and delivery solutions in mobile enterprise. Some strategy explained. Talk about mobility solutions, and Peter will jump in with EMM solutions and different vendors, and compare different vendors with each other. So these are the session objectives. And a structure to get these objectives is talk about challenges, challenges we see as consultants for our customers. Talk about the bento box. I saw some pictures on Twitter yesterday that the lunch was pretty nice, a nice bento box. So I wasn't inspired by that bento box per se, but I already had this session name. You will see later on why we took the name bento box. We talk about security in enterprise mobility, strategy of mobile IT, and then Peter will jump in with EMM explained and SmackDown EMM solutions. That is the 75-minute session structure. So challenges today, business challenges today. When I create a word cloud and I ask people in the audience, okay, what are the challenges you face with your customers? I assume you will find these kind of phrases, these kind of words. Customers with business focus have challenges like, I want to work from anywhere, any. I want to lower cost. I'm not focused on products. I want solutions. My perception to the IT department is that their nickname is Dr. No. That kind of challenges from a business perspective. There are quite some amount of choices from a technology perspective. Technology perspective in this way. When you look at the amount of solutions we can offer as IT professionals, it is challenging to make the right choices. Windows 8, Apple, Android, desktop virtualization, online, offline, AppV, ThinApp, user environment management, RAS, Absence, Liquid Web Apps. You pick a vendor, you pick a brand, you pick a concept, and you have discussion, okay, what is the best choice we can make? So that is quite challenging today. So that's a nice start of this beautiful morning in London City. How do you solve these challenges simply? Well, the business consumer, a different name for end user, the business consumer, he isn't interested in Apple, Google, Microsoft devices or apps. His primary point is, okay, it's about me. How can I do my work better? Or how can I work the best for my organization? And in essence, that is what's all about with consumerization of IT. normally we see these kind of pictures, young people with consumerization of IT, with nice devices, work everywhere, that kind of things. But this can be consumerization of IT as well. So older people with a young mindset working with devices, working with applications. So when I talk about they, I talk about they from an IT pro perspective. So they are the seagulls as well, and they think about this. And they, in the context of consumerization of IT, they have the following feeling.
I want it all! I want it all! I want it all! And I want it now!
Yeah, that was nice in my early days, right? A good start of this morning as well, by the way. And they are the seagulls, and we, as IT pros, are the pelicans. And you will see in this small movie called Nemo what I mean with they and us. And this is how we feel as pelican, and this is how they feel as seagull. So next time when I am watching Nemo with my kids, I think about enterprise mobility and consumerization of IT, that's for sure. So how do you solve challenges? Well, solving these challenges, business challenges and technology challenges, is focus on me. And me is not Peter or Ruben living in the Netherlands in Veenendaal with three kids, but me is, well, the users that's where we are focused on, where we work for. So the business consumer, and the business consumer is all about tomorrow's workspace. Tomorrow's workspace is anywhere, any OS, any browser, any location, any. Tomorrow's workspace is also workspace virtualization. Tomorrow's workspace is also mobile applications. Tomorrow's workspace is also Windows applications. So tomorrow's workspace is well connected to the business consumer. Besides of this workspace, there is a data center as well, or data centers as well. And these are connected. That's what I called tomorrow's data center. And tomorrow is not Saturday flying home, but tomorrow is like a point on the horizon. And these two, like tomorrow's workspace and tomorrow's data center, needs to be connected. When you talk about consumerization as a statement or quote is here to stay. And a business consumer controls IT or controls it. That's the starting point in the industry right now. That's a mind shift as well. But it's key to understand that managing expectations is important as well. What can the end user, the business consumer, receive from IT professionals, but also what may the IT professional expect from the business consumer? That should be in balance. So it's not a one-way trip, the end user expect this from IT professionals. It's the other way around as well. When I was in Japan last year, talking about big bento boxes or big fish I catched a couple of days before, I saw this picture. I eat this kind of food in Japan. This was at Citrix iForum, by the way. Really interesting to see as a European guy and fly to Japan and see how it's structured, how people are organized, how polite the people are. But the food is great as well in Japan, and I like this kind of food. So bento box, and a bento box is like a combination of small portions of food. And a nice bento box is also a sort of presence as well. And this bento box has everything to do with enterprise mobility. Because in the enterprise mobility space, it's about me. It's about access to data, to applications. It's about apps, flavors of apps. It's about devices. It's about manageability as well. Do we manage the device? No. Do we manage the device? Do we manage the application? Do we manage the data? It's part of the bento box as well. Part of this bento box is also self-service. IT store should be part of the bento box. And also collaboration, how people work together, should be part of the bento box as well. Using social media for the enterprise, Podio should be, could be an example, or Socialcast could be an example in that scenario. And any. So any device, any screen, any location, any operating system, any application, anyone, any browser, using online, offline, managed and unmanaged. So these topics are part of the bento box for enterprise mobility. Part of the bento box is also a discussion about, well, devices, or who owns certain devices. So we created this simple diagram. On this side, you'll see IT owns the device. This is the device, and IT owns the device. And on the right side, far right side, it's about it's I own everything, the device, the application, maybe data as well. And it's important for managing expectations that self-reliant or self-supporting freedom and control are different. So when I look at IT owns the device, it's not so important that the user is self-supporting because IT supports them. Freedom is limited and control mostly is focused on a device. When I look at only your own on the other side, it's very important that the colleagues, the business consumers, are self-supporting. They have a broad way of freedom, and control is not a device. Control could be apps or could be data. And managing the expectations about, okay, what device fits? Is it bring your own? Is it buy your own? Is it choose your own? With different explanations. I don't jump in that. But it's important to understand that it's not bring your own or IT owns. There are different flavors. And with these different flavors, it's about self-supporting freedom and control. So bring your own, as well known as well, is a hot topic. I found this smaller survey a couple of days ago from myitforum.com, an IT professional forum. I assume quite some people know that forum. And they had a small survey. And I filled in that survey, and one of the things was, okay, what do you think about bring your own? And quite some amount of people, like almost 30%, well, bring your own is not going to happen. That's not my feeling with bring your own, but that's how the people filled in this survey. And the people who are normally visit myitforum.com are IT professionals. So interesting to see. Bring your own, from my perspective, is the new normal. But, and Jeroen, one of my other friends, will say there's a big but. But that's a typical Dutch joke. But bring your own is not for everyone and not for every situation, as I mentioned with these five pillars before. So yes, bring your own is the new normal, but not for everyone in every situation. We're still in the bento box scenario, and one of the things is overview in application delivery solutions. Overview in application delivery solutions. We created an overview diagram. We updated this diagram a couple of weeks ago, and part of this diagram is delivery of mobile applications as well. So what are the themes to deliver applications to mobile devices? A mobile device is not the MacBook from Peter, but mobile devices more like, okay, Android, iOS, Windows type of mobile devices. Obviously, it's about server-hosted desktops. Yes, I can use server-hosted desktops to deliver Windows classic applications to my end users. What are the benefits? You can see them. So no really redeveloping of these applications. Data is centralized, and the perception is that because it's centralized, it's more secure. The downside is there are no offline capabilities. The downside is end user experience and cost. And the downside is, well, more the perceived performance as well. There are tools in this space who are refactoring the Windows classic applications. ZenApp Mobility Pack, for instance, is such a solution. But overall, our simple conclusion is that using server-hosted desktops to deliver classic Windows applications to mobile devices is the best second choice. So don't use it until you have a good reason to use it. Other solution to bring applications to mobile devices using HTML5 or web applications. Normal, like real web applications, that's what I call web architected applications, are OS, browser, independent, work on LAN, WAN, and Wi-Fi. Not all web applications meet these requirements, but they are still called web applications. Most web applications are not HTML5 applications. Most web applications are not designed or optimized for mobile devices. Yes, they can work, but what is the user experience? How does the user interface look like, for instance? With HTML5, not all features are supported with all browsers on these mobile platforms. Third option to deliver applications to mobile devices is all about, well, rich mobile applications, applications as we use on a daily basis to work with mobile devices. That's what we call rich mobile applications. How do we normally receive these applications is through the consumer store. It's not an enterprise business store. 99.9% of the applications we use on a daily basis are consumer store delivered applications. These applications are isolated from each other on each different platform, iOS, Android, Windows platform. So the application is isolated. And isolation is an important concept to understand with mobile applications. So delivering applications from a mobile application management perspective is challenging. And delivering applications from a mobile device management perspective could be challenging. Not only delivering, but also managing these applications. How do you normally deliver these applications from a MDM or MAM perspective to these devices? Well, is push the application to the device. But when you don't control the device with MAM, it is challenging. It is challenging also because the application is not signed, is not in your, well, trusted environment. So you need to receive, for instance, binaries from the developer, sign it with an SDK or wrap it. And Peter will explain signing with it. SDK and application wrapping later in this presentation. But it's not that easy to deliver, well, applications, rich mobile applications to, well, devices, especially when you don't develop or build these applications by yourself. That's quite challenging in this space right now. When I read, for instance, a couple of blog articles about, okay, it's about mobile application delivery, and there should be a standard, or there are issues with application wrapping, and there are issues with SDK, what should we use? And Peter will jump in with the wrapping and SDK discussion. But it's all about business applications, right? And I saw this this diagram. I will add the source, by the way. I see that the source is not included, but I will add the source of this complete report on this presentation. So when you download the presentation, you'll see the source as well. Interesting to see is that iOS and Android, when you compare these platforms with each other, is that, well, productivity application on iOS is just 2%. 2% of the apps normally on the iOS device that's what I call business applications. And on Android, it's 10%. So we talk about business applications, delivering business applications to endpoints, like mobile devices, but in essence, it's just a small portion of the amount of applications on these devices. I first tried to create my own Dua persona picture, but that didn't work out. I'm not that handy with Photoshop, so I found this one. This is exactly what I mean with Dua persona. Dua persona is an important concept to understand in mobile device and mobile application management. Dua persona has everything to do with Ruben, work, private, device, applications, data. How do I separate personal and private data applications from each other? That's what dual persona is all about. And that's what MDM and MEM, or MEM, mobile information management, is all about. How do I separate these two worlds with different policies, with these policies, encryption level, enabling certain functionality on these devices. But EMM is all about dual persona. And dual persona is not about managing devices. So understanding dual persona is important. Dual persona is about separating work and life in a controlled way from an IT perspective. But dual persona is also about, okay, what's the end user experience? For instance, dual persona could be the just released VMware virtualization platform, where I have a virtual machine running on my specific Android device, and I have my work VM and my, well, personal phone. That is separation as well. Samsung with Knox is creating a sort of dual persona environment as well, security environment as well. So dual persona is important. I mentioned MDM and MDM, MAM a couple of times. There's something else as well. It's called EAS, Exchange Active Sync. And Exchange Active Sync services is, well, call it a lightweight version of MDM. So you almost every customer of PQR is using Exchange services. And therefore, they can use Exchange Active Sync and Active Sync policies to control in some degree stuff on that mobile device through this protocol. So it's not bad. It's important to understand what the benefits and downsides are of EES. And that's what's written down in the EMM SmackDown. MDM, the D is for device. So MDM is device focused. MDM cannot remove user installed apps. So when Franz, for instance, is installing applications with his own account, or not really installing, but you get the point, going to the consumer store and pick an app, application is delivered to the mobile device, these applications cannot be removed via MDM solutions. MDM cannot back up the device, so there are downsides of MDM as well. MAM is application focused. So mobile application management. Just a small side note, one of the friends from AppSense, John Wallace, he wrote an interesting blog post about dangerous portions of Apple pushmail notification services, APNS. APNS is being used by MDM/MAM solutions to update as an update mechanism or a signaling mechanism. For instance, to give a signal, okay, contact my MAM or MDM server for a new policy. But when this APNS service is offline, and it was the case a couple of weeks ago, then it's tough to get, well, new policies, for instance, because MDM and MAM solutions rely on this service from Apple, which is a cloud service, by the way. There's nothing wrong with APNS, but keep in mind that APNS on an iOS device is important to deliver signaling, for instance. Something else, something complete else. Where is what located? This is the hype cycle from Gartner. And I think it's handy to understand where each, well, technology concept is from a Gartner perspective. I don't say they are always right. That's not my point. My point is, okay, you get a feeling, where is MDM? And MDM is what's called slope of enlightenment. It's mature, or it's getting more and more mature. When you look at enterprise application stores, so the red bullet, there's a lot of hype about it. Vendors are developing that kind of technology, but it's not common to use enterprise application stores from a rich mobile application perspective, but also from a Windows application perspective, by the way. Enterprise file share, like ShareFile, for instance, that type of solutions are still in the, well, early phases. When you look at bring your own device, well, you will get the point. Bring your own device, a lot of people talk about bring your own device. With bring your own device, they normally mean, like, okay, phones, maybe tablets, but not laptops. And from my perspective, it's laptops, it's tablet, and it is phone. So bring your own device policy in the Netherlands, bring your own device policy in Germany is completely different. And that's, for instance, one of the reasons why it's still early from a bring your own device perspective, majority of bring your own device. Smartphone virtualization, as I mentioned briefly, is over here. And mobile application management or enterprise mobile application management solutions are really in the early days. Like, I could check out the schedule of last Bri Forum, but my feeling is that we didn't talk about EMM last Bri Forum, or maybe one small session or a small topic in the keynote of Brian, for instance. So it's really early from an enterprise mobility management perspective. One platform to rule them all. That's a nice frame, or one ring to rule them all. This is what we want. It's about Windows, it's about Apple, it's about Android, it's about HTML5. I borrowed this one from Mark Templeton from Citrix, and this is the real, like, this is what we want. Don't be, forget all this stuff about Windows won't make it, it's all about Apple. And then half year later, well, Apple is declining, Windows is increasing. That's interesting. That's a very fast moving market. It's very fast moving. This is what I found yesterday. So 1.5 million devices, mobile devices, and that's not tablets, but phones and tablets, are activated daily. 45 million devices every month. That's pretty substantial. So this is a very rapid growing market, that's for sure. When you look at the differences between market share, so Android is the big one. This one is from ZDNet from yesterday or 2 days ago. So Android is ramping up really fast on a global, worldwide perspective. Windows, with Windows Phone, is on the third place. So they moved BlackBerry from the third place, and iOS today is on the second place. Interesting to see that this is developing. I think when we look at this picture 2 years ago, it was Apple, and Android was just a small portion. And Android will be bigger and bigger and bigger. Some random thoughts about, well, this enterprise mobility subject, this bento box. So I talked about challenges. Challenges from a business perspective, challenges from a technology perspective. We saw a little video clip of Queen. End user want it all. We saw a small video clip of Finding Nemo, my. And the IT pro is, okay, no. Talked about the bento box with different topics. This is the random thought slide. And one of the random thoughts we wrote down is, there is nothing we as IT pros or enterprise mobility solution can do to stop or to solve consumerization of IT. This is just what's going on. This is what will happen and is happening. So don't whine, don't complain, don't whatever. Embrace what's happening and use this, well, energy to help our business consumers make life easier. Bring your own device is not 100%, it won't be 100% bring your own device. But bring your own device will eat some margin, eat some percentage of the, traditional, well-managed IT owns device. And when you look at Gartner numbers, their expectations are 40% of the enterprises will use bring your own device in 2016. For instance, Shell, like the oil company, they released a press release, I think 2 weeks ago, something like that, that 150,000 end users will be primary bring your own device focused. So they will push 150,000 end users to bring your own device policy. That's interesting to see as well. A lot of vendors, and especially the vendors who are anti-Microsoft, talk about the PC era is gone. It's a post-PC era. What I see, it is maybe the opposite. It's a PC plus era. I have my PC plus mobile devices. Plus mobile device X, plus mobile device C. So it's not PC is going away, it's PC plus something else for the majority of my customers. Interesting to see is that Android and malware is in some degree scary. It is attention. And my random thought is that Microsoft Mobile Solutions will be second, will be on the second place, and iOS will be third in 2016. We'll see what happens, but my feeling is that they are ramping up really fast. I know some roadmaps on the Windows Phone stuff. We'll see what happens, but just a random thought. Curious what your thoughts are on Windows Phone later. Also, delivering of rich mobile applications through MAM is messy, especially when you don't develop the application yourself. So that's why we call it the enterprise mobility, and that's why we call it the bento box. A combination of things: workspace management, unified communication, file sharing, mobile application management, mobile device management, but also changing mind shift in consumerization of IT and bring your own device. Two other topics. One of the topics is security in enterprise mobility. Security is an important topic in enterprise mobility. And security is not about securing the device or application, but security should be focusing on data. So it's not about securing device, application, but security should be focused on data. And the other code could be, okay, how do we secure devices so we can keep control on our bytes, on our data? You can say this as well, this quote, plus without annoying end users, or finding the balance between, okay, security and perceived performance. These are the, you call it strategic questions for security in enterprise mobility. So lay out a policy, security policy, which meets the business goals. Have insights what's going on right now with devices, with applications, with business consumers. Know what kind of vulnerabilities are in this space. Understand what the benefits and downsides, for instance, are of Android. Use countermeasures for these issues. So you have no risk, or you have weighted the risk and see, okay, this is a risk, but the amount of money we should normally spend in solving that risk is not in balance. So these are strategic questions for security people in the enterprise mobility space. There are 10 strategic questions for enterprise mobility. So we wrote down 10 points for mobile IT or enterprise mobility strategy. These are our 10 points. So our 10 points go first, what do you want to achieve? So what is your focus as an IT organization or as an organization? What do you want to manage? Do you want to manage data? Do you want to manage applications? Do you want to manage devices? Do you need to manage something at all? Is one of the other questions. Who owns the device, as I mentioned with the five pillars? Who owns the data? Is important as well. And what's the overall application delivery strategy, as I showed in the solution overview? Desktop virtualization, rich mobile application, web application, maybe virtualization platforms from VMware, for instance, could be part of this overall strategy. Morning, Sean. Good to see you. Understand any, as I mentioned before, and make choices. Understand that with any, there are some downsides as well. Understand these downsides. These are written down in a white paper, upcoming white paper. Are there any compliance or regulations where we, part of our industry? When the answer is yes, understand what the impact is for enterprise mobility with focus on compliance and regulation. It's not my hobby to talk about compliance and regulation at all, but it's for some organizations, it's part of the game. Who is the owner of the mobile IT strategy? Who owns this strategy? And what is his or her reason for owning this? Is that saving cost? Is that aligning with business? What is the reason for that? And who is in this strategy team? Network guys, security guys, application development guys, end user or representatives of end users should be part of this team, so should be part of teamwork. And then at last, understand what AppSense, what MobileIron, what Good, what Citrix, what VMware, what the players in the enterprise mobility space are doing. What is their vision? What is their focus? What is their goal? Besides of just making money, what are the products they use and how mature are these products? And then at last, find and search for features which meet the requirements you have. At last, for my section is how to be successful with actually every project. Could be enterprise mobility, could be VDI. How to be successful is to have and to create vision on what you want to achieve, is to execute it correctly, and to make sure that it's adopted by end users. So vision, execution, and adoption, these three should be combined. And when it's one of these three are not there, it's tough to be successful. So vision, execution, and adoption should be part of this project. And when it's part of the project and it's well aligned, then chances are much higher to be successful with that project. And with that, I want to switch gear to Peter, and he will talk about enterprise mobility and different vendors as well. Thanks.
Yes, thank you, Ruben, for laying out the stage where we are at this moment. Next up, enterprise mobility management solutions explained. We've made you can see enterprise mobility management like a puzzle, with multiple pieces that sum up all the possibilities that you can use to securely and support mobile users on mobile devices with mobile applications. Left corner we see mobile device management, mobile application management, information management, some vendors call it mobile content management, and mobile expense management. That's the right corner in the bottom. Before we start on the differences, it's important to note what type of devices there are. Not the real type device, we see here an iPad three times, but who owns the device. If my company owns the device, it's a lot easier for my company to say, okay, we lock down the device. We give you the device, you can use it for the specific tasks that you need that device for. Like in Rotterdam, transportation services use iPads in a kiosk-like mode to access a specific application. There's no need for the user of that specific tablet to use another application. If my company brought me a device, I would probably want to use Angry Birds or install Facebook to tell me that I'm in London. And that's a possibility to use company-owned, personally enabled devices. So there's a managed device, my company bought that device, and I'm able to use applications that are allowed by my company. So there's a white list and that says, okay, you're allowed to install Facebook, you're allowed to install Angry Birds. The last one is bring your own device, where I bought the device and I'm the manager of the device. I want to complete control of my own device and don't want my company to have any control on the device. This should be a starting point to determine what type of enterprise mobility management solution best fits for this type of devices. Let's look at mobile device management. I broke something. There it is. Mobile device management. Focus, of course, device. Control device, completely controlled by IT. It's all about configuring passlocks, provisioning the device with the current, with the right settings for Wi-Fi, for email, for applications that you want to publish on the device, encryption of the device. That's all possible with mobile device management solutions. No matter who owns the device, the one who manages the system has control over the device. So I'm able, as an IT manager, to delete settings on the device, remote wipe the device. I'm not so happy with that as an end user who bought my own device. So you can question yourself if mobile device management is the best solution for bringing your own device solutions. It's important to know there are some very important use cases to use mobile device management. Think about old school users. My own wife, she's not that old, and early 30s. She's walking down with two telephones, two iPhones, one private phone, one business phone. They don't care about using that on one device. That's not what I think of it, but there are still users that think that way in an old school way.
So she is an old school user?
She is an old school user.
What is a Twitter handle?
Please keep it quiet. That's our joke, okay? It's our joke, okay. And then again, like I said earlier, there are specific use cases like the Rotterdam Transportation Service that use the iPad in a kiosk-like mode. So that has multiple users and one specific application that you can't use any other application to use on the device. Important thing to know is about mobile device management that there are limited management capabilities. What we see here is that there are multiple mobile operating systems available. And the thing is that mobile operating systems are developed with security in mind. So any application running on a mobile operating system is only allowed to write in its own space, in its own container. So if I deploy a mobile device management agent or something like that on a device, it's only able to manage itself. So think about it when someone tries to sell you a mobile antivirus scanner, it only is able to scan the own container, the own device. To solve this solution, all the vendors are making APIs to let third-party tools, mobile device management, control the device. So they're making APIs that allow you to lock the camera, to block Siri, to encrypt external storage, etc., etc. But those are limited by what the mobile device vendors, the mobile operating system vendors, are providing to you. So in general, all mobile device management vendors are able to configure exactly the same. They all have access to the same APIs. And they are not the same, so I can configure probably more options on iOS than on Android, than on Windows Mobile. To illustrate that, some screenshots that I used from the Citrix Zen mobile device management solution. Here you see the configuration items available to configure on Zen Mobile. On the left, iOS, in the middle, Android, and on the right, Windows Mobile. At the first glance, you see that there are different type of solutions that you, different amount of solutions, items that you can configure. To make things even worse, as we all know, Android is very, very fragmented. There are multiple types of Android because it's an open system. Vendors are able to access the source code and build in extra management APIs. Like we see here, Samsung has their own features. HTC in the bottom also adds their own features. So Android is not Android on any other phone. There's a difference in Android for Samsung, Android for HTC, or for some other phones that you might be using. It's important to be aware of before choosing your mobile device management solution. Not all features are available on all platforms. Application management is the next thing. With application management, the focus is primarily on the application. No longer manage the device, just focus on that specific application. Deploy an application to a device, and if we can control the application with policies, able to start when Wi-Fi is available, able to start with extended password authentication or something like that, we can secure the data that is stored in the container from the application. And we have a way to allow business applications to run on personal devices, no matter what type of device it is. But at the time the user starts an application, it's prompted with credentials to enter his credentials, passcode or something like that, and he can use the application. It also makes it possible to selective wipe that application. If I remove the application, I remove the data contained with it, like a container. to be able to deliver applications, we have to do something with the application, a bit of intelligence add to the application, something like, there are multiple methods for this. For instance, application wrapping. The application vendor, or if you develop in-house applications or through an ISV, deliver you with the binaries, an IPA file or APK file, and you're able to use that application through a wrapper, which brings a wrap on the application, and then the management platform becomes effective. At the time the user starts the application, that wrap will ignite or will check for the current credentials and current policy if you're able to start, if you're allowed to start that application. Another method is the use of software development kits. That's the way you have to ask the software vendor to create an application using a specific software development kit. And the challenge is that with software development kits and application wrapping, they are at this moment vendor-specific. So I choose mobile application management from, let's say, Good. I can only use these applications to deliver it through Good, not through AirWatch or something like that. So there's no standard at this moment where you can ask software vendors to develop applications for some type of management platform. Another thing to note is that we can only manage applications that are managed through mobile application management services. So if I'm able to download applications next to mobile application management from the public application stores, like Google Play Store or the Apple App Store, I'm not able to control that application, to put policies on that application. Something important to note. So if I'm able to open or install Dropbox on my personal device, and I have corporate applications, and I want to block access to Dropbox, I want to prevent installation of Dropbox, that's not possible, because I only manage the application. What we can do is put a policy on the application that we delivered through mobile application management solutions to prevent opening that specific file or specific application with Dropbox, with personally installed applications. So you can create a boundary to block to prevent data loss through other applications. What you will see, however, for instance, on the Apple iOS, you will see the applications when you try to open a file. You will see open in Dropbox, you will see open in Evernote. That is iOS specific, it's iOS default. It will show you all the applications that are able to open the files. You will experience, however, that you're not able to open the file and only open the file with a specific application that you are configured in your mobile application management solution. When you develop applications, it's something to think about is, do you just develop applications for Android, for iOS, or Windows Phone, or all? Or what platform are you focusing on? There's no standard to develop an application that runs on Android, on iOS, or Windows Phone. Okay, HTML5, that might be a solution, but if you are using application device-specific features, you need to install something on the device, something to think about. You might think that this is the perfect fit for bring your own device in regarding to mobile devices. If I'm able to manage the application on a device is owned by the user, is managed by the user, it might be the best fit. Great challenge is about application wrapping. How do you end up with the application? You might ask Citrix or Microsoft for a unified messaging client that you want to deliver through your own mobile application management solution. Not sure if that's going to work. Another thing about mobile application management solutions is that they are offering you types of security for email attachments, secure access to internal web resources, like SharePoint or something like that, and secure file sync solutions. And email is an important thing for mobile devices. Probably the killer application that we are all using on our mobile phones. There are multiple ways to secure email. As I explained earlier, mobile device management is limited by what the mobile operating system vendors provide you with, within their APIs. So there are no tools except forwarding or moving between different email profiles to secure your email, your corporate email, next to the personal email client. So if I'm using a native email client, for instance, on my iOS device, I'm not able to prevent copy-paste or share data from my native mail application with other applications. That might be a difficult solution for your, that might be something that you don't want to end up with. What we can do, however, is to secure attachments. Mobile application vendors provide you with tools to let attachments be encrypted in a secured container and only allowed to open if you're allowed to do that. So that will be a check if you is with the application management system. Another way to secure email on your mobile device is by delivering you, presenting you a different third-party mail client. That mail client is like any other mobile application management, is controlled by policy rules. So if I'm allowed to start the application, it's determined on the time that I start the application. Am I allowed to start it? Do I need to enter my password? Do I have a Wi-Fi connection available or something like that? Multiple rules apply, and that is a way to control access to my mobile email client. That also gives me the opportunity to control the complete mail client to prevent that users copy and paste data between applications. Because the mail client, the third-party mail client, is secure, I am able to control it. I can control what type of data I can copy and paste or use in other applications. That is a way to secure your email. However, what I think is challenging is, are your users able to use a third-party mail client? Just a question. I'm very happy with the native mail client on my iOS device. Are you willing to use a third-party mail client to allow your corporate mail to reach your corporate mail? Hanso? iOS, native mail client or third-party mail client? Anyone? Native? Native? I was expecting more native users, To be honest, the vendors provide you with a good mail client. For instance, good, like the Citrix at work mail application, adds extra functionality to the mail client, like adding attachments to an appointment, or see scheduling information, free booking information when I make an appointment from that calendaring app. So there are some advantages of the third-party mail client, but in general, I really want to use the native application like I'm used to do now. Secure web browsers is another way. If we can deliver a secure web browser on your application, and again, determine when you can start that application, apply policies on it, we are able to secure access, allow you to have secure access to internal resources. And in many cases, dependent on a specific vendor, without opening extra firewall ports or additional firewall ports on your remote access solution. The web browser running on your mobile device intercepts the internal addresses and allow you to access those through the mobile device of mobile application management gateway that you're probably running. So in that way, you can safely allow your users to access internal resources like SharePoint or any other web application that you're currently using. Other vendors, other possibilities are secure file sync solutions to securely synchronize files with your mobile devices, with your PC, with any other device that you're allowed to use it on, like we used to do with Dropbox. But this time, probably in a secure way, in a managed, controlled way by IT. Another way of enterprise vulnerability management solutions is expense management. I think this is a very small part of enterprise vulnerability management. It's mainly to prevent excessive roaming usage on your telco operators to prevent a large cost. We had a colleague, he was visiting the States last year during his first holiday. He enabled data roaming on his phone, but turned off all the push notifications. So he thought, okay, I'm safe. Then again, he started shooting pictures. They were uploaded to PhotoStream. So he came home with a 2,000 euro phone bill. Oh, oops, yeah, okay, PhotoStream. Yeah, it's constantly syncing with the Apple iCloud. So if you want to prevent that, expense management solutions, and they're all some part of us are incorporated in mobile device management solutions, provide you with ways to control data roaming, to limit it, to block it, or send users a message when they are reaching some limits. Fourth piece from the puzzle is information management. Information management, some vendors call it mobile content management, is probably the best solution for securing data on your mobile device. What if you don't need to control the application, but just control the information? Then we can let the user decide which application he wants to use to edit his applications. His information. Because consumerization of IT, let the user bring their own devices. Why not let them bring their own applications? And with application management, you're still saying, okay, here you have access to your corporate data, but you have to use application Y. With mobile information management, the user is able to decide which application he wants to use. At this moment, however, there's not a real solution available. So there's no way to allow this to happen at this moment. There are some initiatives like Samsung Knox might be a solution on the device level, but only limited to specific Samsung Android versions to allow access through a generic API. But if we look at Good for Enterprise, they allow software vendors to create for Good. That's an application that is signed by the software development kit from Good that are delivered through the public stores like Apple App Store, but are working with the software development kit to access a secure container on your device. That might be a solution to fix these challenges. Another way is Symantec Shield program. They allow you to software vendors to create applications, again, signed with, or wrapped, I must say, not signed, wrapped with the Symantec application wrapper, delivered through public application stores, and again, allow you to control access to your data. The difficulty with mobile information management is that a mobile application needs to know about the other container. Applications are only aware about the information that is stored within their own container, unless you add extra intelligence, like we do with using a software development kit at the moment we are compiling that application. So if I just download some application like GoodReader or another application from the application store, like from Apple or the Google Play Store, how is that application supposed to know about some secured container on my device? That's the challenge, and let's hope that that will fixed in the future. This should be a great solution to support mobile enterprise vulnerability management solutions. So to sum up, application enterprise vulnerability management, four main pillars: mobile device management, application management, information management, and expense management. You might question something about the titans are mobile device management on the one side, mobile application management on the other side. Which one's best? Which one, when to use what? Well, it all depends on the use case. There are, like we mentioned earlier, there are still many, many use cases to use mobile device management. Let's say that we want to control some applications that we can't deliver with mobile application management solutions. Mobile device management might be the solution to solve that problem. There are still specific use cases where people don't want to use their own devices to work. Like Ruben showed earlier with this graph, that over 30% of the IT professionals don't think that bring your own device will be a reality. Perhaps they fit in the mobile device management space. What we see, however, is that all the vendors are focusing on, not really focusing, they provide solutions for both. Traditional mobile device management solutions enter the application management space. Application management solutions enter the mobile device management space, so they can fit, present you with a whole management platform to choose whatever fits your purpose. Then we go to the smackdown of the AMM solutions. Time checking. I broke it again. No, PowerPoint's not responding. We should have used the Mac. Ah, there it is. Phew. No demos, and still it almost broke. In the EMM Enterprise Mobility Management Smackdown that we are about to release, we added these vendors. And these vendors, we made a selection. What vendors should we take up in this document? And we looked at the Magic Quadrants from Gartner, which are the major players within the space, and added some interesting for evaluation purposes, like Cisco Meraki. And we also noted in this slide Microsoft ActiveSync. We didn't incorporate ActiveSync within the application Smackdown, like Ruben already told. It's a very, very lightweight MDM solution. If you're using Exchange and you want at least configure a pass lock or prevent that another user is able to, prevent data loss when a mobile device is lost, you can use Exchange ActiveSync for just a tiny bit. All other vendors are incorporated in the Smackdown. Let's go. Find out what are the major findings. Like I said earlier, the traditional mobile application management vendors enter mobile device management. I think probably the best example here is Citrix with Zen Mobile. Citrix released Cloud Gateway last year. Cloud Gateway was a mobile application management solution. They bought Zenprise, and now they have both. Again, other vendors like Good for traditional mobile device management solutions and enter the mobile application management space. I've spoken with Good representatives, and they said, "Yeah, we are one of the leaders in the Magic Quadrant from Gartner on mobile device management. But mobile device management is just a tiny bit what we do at this moment. So please remove us from the mobile device management space and let us be well known as the application management provider." We've seen quite some similarities. Obviously, the MDM features, like I've told you earlier, the management APIs are generally available for all the vendors. So all the vendors are able to do exactly the same on a platform. So in general, all features are the same. Mobile application management features, they're all allowed of able to deploy Android applications, iOS, Google Play Store, Windows Mobile applications, and they also support Google Play Store and Apple App Store apps. We're missing at this moment Windows Store applications are not yet available through mobile application management solutions. And as you would expect, they all support multiple platforms, of course Active Directory and all the major email platforms. The Enterprise Vulnerability Management Smackdown is currently under review. Version 1 will be released next Thursday at Synergy. Probably available through brianmadden.com, so watch that space. We will post a blog post somewhere around next week.
Next week will be I think quite some interesting news from Synergy. So we'll discuss with Brian and Gabe if it's a good timing to write a blog post about enterprise mobility management. We'll see how that will work out. And also with Jack his upcoming book, see how that fits in the same time frame.
So we think that will be next Thursday, but it might be. It won't be sooner, but it will be probably later. Okay, watch that space. Well, we've included AirWatch. AirWatch, just a high-level overview, is ranked leader in the Magic Quadrant. Offers you complete solution, mobile device management and application management. Application wrapping is done through a software development kit. They offer you mobile content management, with comprehensive possibilities to monitor what type of information is stored on the device and what changes are made on the device. It is primarily as a cloud-based solution, but if you want, there is also an on-premises solution available. AppSense Mobile Now, 100% SaaS-based application from the cloud, offers you the possibilities to mobile for mobile device management and application management. And if you put in data now, which is an on-premises virtual appliance, it allows you to file sync application data through numerous devices and on a secure and effective way. Cisco Meraki is, who knows Cisco Meraki? No one? It might be a fun solution to look at if you're well-known with Microsoft Intune. Cisco Meraki is a free solution, offers you the possibility to distribute applications to Windows, iOS, Android, and macOS applications, and is a lightweight MDM solution. But I must say, I'm very attracted by the solution if you look at it for, let's say, smaller companies. You've got it set up and running in only 15 minutes, so it might be a great product to look at for not a serious application enterprise management solution, to be honest. Zen Mobile, of course, Citrix Zen Mobile, well known. Two different solutions. On one side, the Zen Mobile, the former Zenprice product, and the Zen Mobile Solutions Bundle, which currently is the Zenprice product combined with the older Cloud Gateway solution. They both offer you a solution. Mobile MDM is available as a cloud service. You can choose whether be on-premises or through the cloud. If you choose the Zen Mobile Solutions Bundle, it's always on-premises. Citrix uses application wrapping to deploy mobile applications, so you need to have an IPA file, wrap it through the application wrapper, and you are able to deploy the application. Secure email, secure web browsing through the applications that they provide you. And if you want to use secure file sync, you need ShareFile, which is an optional component. Mobile Iron, large install base. Again, as with AirWatch, ranked leader in Gartner's Magic Quadrant. They allow you to choose. They both have application wrapping and software development kits to make applications, mobile applications, able to deliver through mobile application management solutions. Again, secure mail client, you're able to choose. Nitrodesk Touchdown, they use a third-party client, or Mobile Iron Android Email Plus. And for secure file sync, they partner with other partners. Mobile Iron is available as a cloud service or on-premises, and they call it then the virtual smartphone platform. Windows Intune. Windows Intune allows you to deploy applications to Windows, Mac, to Android and iOS. Allows you to manage the devices, primarily mobile device management. Doesn't offer you a file sync solution, but and it's not needed to wrap the application. It's important to know. Good. Next one. I have to ramp up a little bit. Sorry about the time. Good for enterprise suite. Application wrapping through a software development kit. They have some email, some clients available, some applications available. And what's important to know about Good is they offer you Good Dynamics. And Good Dynamics is a framework for application developers to sign the application with a Good SDK and let the applications be available available for download through the public application stores. If you look at the iTunes for Apple application store, look for Good. You will see some applications, iAntuate, some other applications, and they are signed with the software development kit from Good, so they are allowed to access the secure container from Good. So it's some solution for the mobile information management thing. Important to know, there's a combined architecture. You need an on-premises Good server to allow access, but there's always communication with a common cloud-based network operations center. If we all know RIM, BlackBerry, RIM uses the technology from Good to allow synchronization with BlackBerry. Advantage, there's no need to open additional firewall ports from the outside to your internal environment. All information is stored from the inside out. Symantec, great player, of course, offer you MDM and mobile application management features through three products. Mobile security, obviously only available on Android and Windows, Windows Mobile. You know, like I said earlier, mobile security on an iOS device doesn't make any sense because it's only able to secure that's his own container. Application wrapping is the way to go for internal applications. And they are now working on the Symantec Shield program to allow Symantec ready application in the public stores to again allow access to the secured containers. Available both as cloud as an on-premises solution. VMware, we have included VMware as well. We were having some high expectations from VMware because of all the buzz going around about the mobile hypervisor space. During our research for this Enterprise Mobility Management Smackdown, we ended up with, how do I say it best?
Oh, they didn't meet our expectations.
Our expectations. there's some interesting stuff released 1-2 days ago. And you have specific phones to have a mobile OS corporate-wise and personal-wise. That might be a solution, but only works on specific mobile phones. So how it deals with bring your own computing is bring your own device.
That's for Android, and they have a mobile solution for iOS, but it's still in early days within VMware.
Yeah, it's all part of the Horizon Workspace suite. Expect some news around June about new features. Well, you can ask what's the best solution? Well, the popular answer is it depends. Well, we provide you with some ways to get behind that it depends. Like Ruben explained earlier, there are 10 points for the mobile IT strategy. It's important to focus on strategy first and then later on the features. So the management smackdown goes in all the differences between the products. Don't start with looking at those features to find out which solution fits your purpose. Find out what's your mobile IT strategy and then look what vendor, what product fits best.
So this EMM Smackdown is the fourth Smackdown white paper, or upcoming for Smackdown white paper. The goal of this presentation is not to talk about the white paper. That's just side discussion actually. It's talk about what are the challenges in our industry. It's talk about the bento box. What's the combination of solutions in the bento box in the enterprise mobility space. Talk about mobile device management, mobile application management, software development kit, application wrapping, bring your own consumerization of IT. A lot of topics are covered. Some a little bit more detailed, some overview. that was our approach to give overview as well. So we hope that this session meets your expectations. When you have feedback of things which could be better, or when you have feedback of things which are great, it's always good to have feedback. Writing such a white paper, EMM Smackdown, same as, to be honest, like end user user environment management, is quite challenging. Aaron knows that for sure. When we wrote the EMM, so user environment management Smackdown, like 3 years ago, it was like, let's see what happens in this space, because there's not so much written as a big document in this space. And that's what we see in EMM as well, so enterprise mobility as well. So writing this stuff, investigating this stuff, is challenging, and same as with user environment management. And it's what we see with within EMM as well. So when you have feedback on the white paper, when you have feedback on this presentation, when it's good, fill in the evaluation forms. When it can be better, let us know. It's always good. My sign, some colleagues, some people know, my sign of good, and not good as a solution, but good like celebrating something, is a mojito. That's what I learned from my coach. So celebrate success is one of my pitfalls. Always looking forward and not enjoying what you've established. And enjoying what you've established is drinking mojito. So when we, tonight maybe, we'll see how it will work out. Tonight we will drink a mojito on this session. It feels good to share knowledge, and hopefully it feels good for you as well. With that, thank you for your time, and have a good day.
Thank you very much.